All right, hello everybody. This is Starman, and welcome back to Let's Play the Dungeon of Naheulbeuk, or Naheulbeuk, or however the heck it's pronounced. It kind of depends upon which character is speaking at the time. But anyway, last time you remember, we entered the dungeon. And we started trying to find the rest of our party. Which, so far, we've managed to find everybody except for the barbarian and the dwarf. But looking at the map, I just realized that we had not gotten back this way. It looks like we just found a ritual room of some type, which has yielded some loot of some type. And something I've discovered about this game, as little as I've played into it, it's very important to check every corner because you can actually find some useful things stashed in the corner. Case in point. And this is actually down toward where we first started. Okay, and this has yielded a minor ring of intelligence. You really can't know how lacking you are in the intelligence department since it's the one that does all the reflecting, but with this ring you have a more accurate estimate. Or so you think. And there's also scented armbands, incredibly soft and comfy. These armbands are enveloped in a delicate cloud of raspberry fragrance. Can also be used in battle. Now that there's some more loot down here. Ham and withered broccoli. Broccoli is full of potassium and vitamin B, however, is not edible for barbarians, it is not dripping in animal fat. Also cures the poison status. So yeah, very important lesson to be learned here. Loot, loot, loot some more. Anyway. Looking over some of the gear that we've gotten before. I think that obviously...
Careful with my books!
The Ring of Intelligence should go to our Wizardess. The Care Trainer armbands, I believe, are meant for the Ranger.
How can people put their hands in my pockets?
Center armbands go to her. And I think that does it for all the other gear that we've got handy. So, onward to finding the rest of our party. Yeah, there's a lever we pulled earlier. Dungeon Express Delivery Notice. An authentic Dungeon Express delivery notice addressed to a so-called Zandagar. It seems that the recipient was not here at the time of delivery. But there's also some light beer. And let's see what light beer does. Brewed for the servants, bums, innards, and goblin guards. Much you can say about this beer is that it's not foul water. The small amount of alcohol it raises increases courage. Weird, I don't see the door that they came through earlier. Well, that actually might be this door. It was just filmed at a different angle earlier, but okay. And there's nothing else in that pantry, so let's move on to finding the rest of the party.
Come on, have a taste of my axe, you orc scum. There's one dwarf yet in this dungeon who still draws breath.
Yes, we'll kick your face in.
You're lucky we're here. You're in over your head.
Nothing's over my head. I'm tall for a dwarf.
Okay, the dwarf and barbarian are in a tough spot. You have to help them before they become overwhelmed. Begin combat when you're ready. Now the ranger is equipped with a secondary weapon. He has a new tactical option. He can perform ranged attacks. Play your turn as you see fit. Although it is suggesting that coming over here and shooting at those guys would be advisable. Or at least it seemed to be doing that. Though I'm thinking this might be a better option.
Hold your ground!
Yeah, boost everybody's defense, probably a good idea right now. The barbarian is a powerful, nimble fighter. He can move a little further than his companions, and he hits hard. However, his protection is low, and precision is not that good. The good thing with the barbarian is he's rather straightforward. His first skill, Steel Barrage, targets all three tiles in front of him. Select the Steel Barrage, and let's check out what happens if you attack these orcs. So basically, cleave. Another one bites the dust. Leaving the spot is still too dangerous for now, as it will get you hit by two opportunity attacks. You don't have much choice there, so you shouldn't end your turn. Your enemies have skills too. These orcs can knock you down, although there's a chance to resist thanks to your physical resistance. A knockdown character will skip their turn and is easier to hit. Our dwarf is a noble descendant of Gurgly Shyass, and as such was predestined to an adventurer's life. He has enough hit points to endure the charge of a rabid troll, but is rather slow. He loves heavy armor, shields, and gold coins. So, you know, a dwarf. The dwarf is in trouble. Weakened and surrounded, he may well die before the next turn if you leave him like this. Time to talk about defensive stance, a skill that all your characters know. Select in the action bar, and then select the dwarf. Defensive stance raises your character's protection and lowers the precision of any enemy attacking you until their next turn. It'll also protect them from critical hits. However, a character who is in defensive stance can't perform attack of opportunity. Defensive stance can be canceled if the character gets stunned, knocked over, or scared. Select it, and select the dwarf, who is at full health, so he's really not that bad off, all things considered. The shortest path to your companions is blocked by crates. Thankfully, some elements of the environment can be destroyed, like fragile-looking crates. Normally it takes two hits to break them, but the ogre is so brutal he can destroy them in one, plus he can't miss this attack. Attack this crate and open up the pathway to your companions. You just got hit by a critical hit, and the barbarian is now unconscious. He's not fully out of action yet. We have a limited number of turns to rescue him with a healing potion or a spell. If you are a character who's fallen unconscious in battle, will suffer an injury. Healing in battle. The Wizard has a spell of Cure Minor Wounds. It's not very powerful, but it can be used at range, i.e. 5 tiles. Select Cure Minor Wounds. Unconscious character can be healed with potions, but will suffer an injury after standing up. If the character hasn't been healed before the unconscious stage ends, they'll be out of action until the end of combat. Cast Cure Minor Wounds on the Barbarian.
Must pee.
And that's it for her turn. These enemies can immobilize if a crippling strike. Immobilized character can stack normally but can't move, which also makes them easier to hit. Okay, I think we'll move the elf here. Have her do range attack, actually. We'll go ahead and go for the ricochet, even though like I said, I think I've determined that there's a pretty good chance that if she can accidentally hit the dwarf and get away with it, she'll do it, but... So, Ranger. Okay, Barbarian. Go for the weaker target. Now use a special attack. Yak Yak Charge deals damage and knocks over your target.
And boom! Bailey!
Unfortunately, he can't move any further, but that got him taken out. Unfortunately, that used up all his movement. Now he's blocking off that orc. That unfortunately knocked him down. And her powerful spells where we can't do much at the moment. And that double moved her. Keep forgetting that. Okay. Thankfully.
Didn't see that one coming, did you?
Take this, chicken shit!
Alright, well, I thought he couldn't move. I guess that's been cured. Yeah, the dwarf, as has been noted, has a really limited range. He can't move that fast either. And he is unconscious again. Yeah, Barbarian is not doing nearly as well as he did last time, but thankfully... You know, Wizardress is there to try and heal him up in a bit. Unfortunately... And okay, yeah, he is beyond her range, but I think... At this point, he's got enough targets close. He'll choose somebody who isn't. Ah! Your enemies are fleeing. They will try to run to the yellow area that just appeared. If they make it, you'll earn less XP. And some battles won't be your retreat, and they'll fight to their last breath. Stop them before they reach the retreat area.
I don't need you guys.
Good work. Click back when you're ready to move on. So heal everybody.
I was thirsty.
Okay, so we now also have Universal Antidote, an easy dungeon potion. Theoretically negates most poisons. Remember, you can't negate a poison after suffering a frothy death. Books of Strategic Retreat. Sometimes the only difference between cowardice and prudence is the thickness of a supple lover's soul. Leaving without a sound is better than dying in a gurgle. Dodgy Pot. This rusted pot is covered with a thick, goopy layer of congealed fat. It can protect you from goblins and cook them afterwards. And another healing potion. We'll, of course, take everything.
Look out! It's a weirdo!
Old dude with staff. A wizard!
It looks more like a broom. Hello?
Hey, pay no attention to me. In fact, you shouldn't even be able to see me. It's just my invisibility ring acting up again.
He's a wizard.
He looks more like a janitor.
Well, that's very reductive. I'm the head cleaning operative of this dungeon's mortuary maintenance, Janos Hitor. I deal with the corpses left behind by adventurers. The smell would get unbearable without me.
Akala yum yum orkum.
He's just gonna eat this orc if you don't mind.
I don't. As long as the floor stays clean, and it means less work for me.
Ew, I'm gonna be sick.
We're looking for a way to the next floor.
Usually, people like to take the stairs.
Yes, but there are some magic locks.
Really? Didn't notice them. I must be immune, thanks to a spell of mine which enables me to go wherever blood has been spilt.
We could make him take it to the dungeon, Master.
Yes, take us with you.
Nuh-uh. No time for such threats. Got work to do.
A wizard. That was a wizard.
He realized he should withdraw with haste.
Who's this haste guy?
A consumable you find can be equipped on your character's inventory. And we will stop to do this even though it says to keep moving forward. Because we do have some new equipment to move and
if it stinks, it's my boots.
Anyway, we've got him back in fighting shape now. Armbands of moderate brutality. If you can't beat them, hit harder, you coward, barbarian saying. Blood of these armbands has been tanned in the blood of vanquished enemies. Show-offs love them. Savage harness. Barbarians spend most of their life half-naked. They have a utilitarian outlook on fashion. Twisted veil, technically a claymore. Well, you could use it as a paddle, I guess. And old leather boots. When it rains, feet get wet, barbarians saying. The feet odor is starting to get interesting. And the dwarf.
No way I'm giving it away!
Dwarven warrior helmet. A simple, reliable helmet, typical of mountain dwarves. Other races mostly use them as ashtrays or as flower pots. Rusty dwarven armor. This armor can probably take some slashes from goblin swords before it crumbles to dust, but there's no way to know exactly how many. Don't forget your rust scraper and bandages. Your first lame-ass axe. Found for free in any baby back bitch dungeon starter. Mijul's rotting pavis. Pavis. Looks like there's a halfling who's missing the door to his burrow. Anyway, strategic retreat.
The poor get poorer.
Bratuf Soglaf.
And the ogre is now wearing the pot as a helmet. Because why not? So, that done, let's press on. And, okay, yes, I guess I will need to... You'll note that every character...
Do I have something to jot down some quick notes?
Who has a belt...
What's in there? Ah, my bag.
Hands off my gold, my precious gold!
How ironic for a thief to empty his own pockets.
Yeah, every thief, or every character who... has an empty space on their belt can equip an item. can just use that potion on their own. And hey, there's another lever. Let's randomly pull this and make sure nothing bad happens. And this leads us back to where we started.
So, let's update the map.
Looking pretty up to date. Although, we do have a reinforced door here, so now we've got the ogre. Let's check that out. Well, there was the hope that we'd find something useful there.
Ha! You wimp!
Now, just for the giggles. And no, it still defaults to the ogre trying to do it.
Knock harder! Knock harder!
Okay, well, this does bring up an interesting point, because typically the ranger will be the one leading the party. And we're about to get to a point where it actually will show you how you can have different party members lead to have different things happen. I'm going to see what happens if I let the thief take charge first. And if it will skip this, because then it looks like, yes, his ability does kick in. Because the thief, if you have him take the lead, he will automatically start looking for traps in a certain radius. But just for the fun dialogue, let's see what happens.
I think I'm hearing some vague chanting in the distance.
Yeah, I think it's too quiet.
This room might be trapped. Beware. We should find some other way.
I don't listen to you anymore. You're a downer and you bum me out.
I just have a survival instinct.
Coward!
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What's with all this shit talking?
Put on them kissy buddies.
Oh, that just hurt.
Oh, dang it. A trap.
I told you so.
You should have detected this trap.
No one asked me to.
What? You... Well, it's official. I'm going to ignore the thief now.
Anyway, now we're asking you. Would you mind looking out for traps, please?
Well, I'll see what I can do.
Don't get where we're wasting our time with this guy.
Neutralizing a trap is a risky endeavor which could bring one to a gruesome end.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Okay, so... Select the thief to leave the party. And this trap sense should kick in before that trap does. So now we can attempt to disarm it.
Slowly pull on the latch.
And we now have an explosive bomb, which the thief can equip to use as a one-shot. Damage device. So. And yes, this does kind of highlight the monotony of how bad it is when you have the thief going first to search for every possible thing and. It's like, hey, there's a party. I mean, you know, not an adventuring party, but the other type of party.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Whoa, what the f*** is going on now?
Welcome to the fabulous contestants of our show, The Wheel of Misfortune, hosted by our sponsor, Durandil Swords. With Durandil Swords, friend of all warlords.
Talking goblin. Impossible.
Huh, he must be half goblin.
Yeah, but what species could look at a goblin and want to have its babies?
Mix violence and alcohol and bam! Anything can happen.
Here we have our squinty-eyed ranger, our headstrong barbarian, voracious ogre, an almost but not quite wizard, a gawky elf, a chicken shit thief, and a dwarf. You know, just a dwarf. Welcome, dear contestants. Have a go at our wheel and discover your destiny with our sponsor, Guthelm Helmets. With a Guthelm Helmet, you can ransack an entire kingdom.
If there's loot to be made, we should trade. We'll kill him after. Come on, I'm giving this shit a spin.
Wait. Be careful. This game could be cursed in some way.
Great! Our friendly contestants just won 5,000 gold coins, courtesy of our sponsor, Gorzine Detergent. Gorzine, to scrub gore and beans for battles and cuisine.
Epic!
Yeah!
And since we're not stingy, we'll throw in some healing for the entire party.
I do have some split ends.
It sounds too good to be true.
This won't end well, I'm sure of it.
We'll take another spin. More! More gold! Again! More!
Don't be afraid. Have a good, strong spin. You can never lose with our sponsor, Lorelei-Ann's Shampoos.
That is a good shampoo.
Yeah, but I'm not sure it can help us untangle this mess.
Okay, now, we probably could leave well off enough alone and stop here and be satisfied with the fortune we've got, but where would the fun be in that? But I'm going to go ahead and stop this chapter here, and we will continue on with this little game show next time. See you then.